If you love the ISUPK, stay in the loop. Go to Google Play and download the new user-friendly One West ISUPK app and get exclusive footage to our online classes and street speaking videos. Also, the Black Watch podcast, hosted by Commanding General Yohanna, the leader of the Nation of Israel. It's real easy to stay in tune with the ISUPK and the information we're putting out. Just go to Google Play and type in One West UPK app and hit download. Let's get it in. Don't be left out.
And taking pictures with some fat pedophile. Black people getting the Christmas spirit is, I'm about to rob this cat so I can get these Jordans for my son. I'm about to bust in this T-Mobile store to get these phones so I can sell them. I'm about to risk my life selling drugs so I can find a way to support my family. Right, where do you think we get that from, Matt? That comes from America. That's their culture. That's how they got this country, the water cap. That's how America got this country, by robbing, stealing, murdering. And when we follow American culture, we destroy ourselves by doing the same thing. American culture is destructive for black people. And New Year's is just another pitfall for us to be punished by the Lord, man. We keep reading.
Can two walk together except they agree?
Drop that. Give me Proverbs 28:13, man. The Bible says, can two walk together except they agree? When you went out and celebrated New Year's, guess what you told the white man? That I agree with your philosophy. I agree with what you're doing to my people. You know why? Because two can't walk with each other unless they agree. So whoever you going and hanging out with and whoever culture you following, that's who you agree with. I'm gonna have a lot of you all out, a lot of you political wannabe Negroes. You uppity Uncle Tom Negroes in D.C. just want to be part of white man society so bad. Y'all thought y'all was changing the world when you went and voted. Guess what you told the white man when you went to go vote? That you agree with his political system. And guess what? America's political system has passed laws to destroy black people.
That's right.
This is not my opinion. This is historical. Do you know at one point in time it was legally okay to have slaves? By law, it was okay to have slaves. Do you know the white man passes laws right now where a black man can't even defend himself? We in D.C., I know y'all know, you can't even get in a fight and defend yourself in D.C. without getting charges, all type of stupid charges, man. Because this place oppresses the Lord's people, man. This place is not good for black people, and we shouldn't agree with their culture or their ways. Meanwhile, a white man can tweet about setting the bomb off. He can order the bomb parts and nobody blinks an eye. And then turn around and blows up a store and we forget all about it. How come we ain't talking about that devil that blew up that bomb in Tennessee? How come the cops didn't go and arrest him? How come the cops didn't profile him and pull him over? But let me say the white man is the devil. Y'all want to stop me. We the terrorists because we say the white man is the devil. When there's actual terrorists out here in America. And they're white. And they're devils, man.
That's right.
And they're patriots.
That's right.
You understand? We got to come back to our culture. The white man's culture is destructive. And it doesn't benefit our people. Read that.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 28, verse 13. He that covereth his sins.
He that what?
Covereth his sins.
The Bible says, he that covereth his sins. This is important to understand, because our people don't realize when we went out and celebrated New Year, we were sinning against our God.
Right.
We were sinning against the only one who's actually looking out for our people.
Right.
When we went and celebrated that Greek Roman white man holiday, we were sinning against the Lord. And now that people are talking, now that we're bringing up the fact that we're sinning, a lot of our people don't want to hear the truth. They want to keep their sins covered, man, because they're sinning. You understand? You know why? What they say, a hit dog holler, man. Sinners are offended when we bring out the fact that we can't sin. You understand? If I say it right now, if you touch kids, you're disgusting. The person that gets mad when I say that, you would assume, well, he must touch kids, because why is he mad? Why would you, that, if it don't pertain to you, why are you mad? Well, guess what? We're telling our people, don't sin. So those who are angry at that are sinners. And I'm going to help you because I love you, black man. Because we love you, Hispanic, Native American, Indian man. I'm going to tell you something. We all were sinners at one point back here, man. But we understand this one thing about the Bible. Read.
He that covereth his sins shall not prosper.
Shall not what?
Not prosper.
Everybody made a New Year's resolution. New year, new me. 2021 is the year of prosperity. Some of y'all listen to that pastor lie to y'all for 4 hours sitting in church till 12 o'clock. This is a year of prosperity. Get it ready, get it ready, get it ready. God's got a blessing. It's the shift, the anointing, money, tithes, all that garbage, man. Why do we listen to that garbage? You understand? The pastor was preaching prosperity. When the Bible says the pastor is not going to prosper, you know why? Because the pastor is covering his sins. That same pastor that's telling you 2021 is going to be your year of prosperity, that pastor's hiding the fact that he's sleeping with brothers' wives. That pastor's hiding the fact that he's molesting children. That pastor's hiding the fact that he's stealing the church's money. And you know what you do when you follow after the pastor? You learn to cover your sins as well. And that's why the black community cannot prosper. That's why that New Year's resolution means absolutely nothing. 2021 is going to be worse than 2020, man. If you're a sinner, man. If you are a sinner, this year is going to be worse for you.
Right. And what that brother said, so heavy about church. I ain't been Christian in about 10 years. So I forgot. Right. But, you know, all of us used to go to church on Christmas Eve. And you go to church and you kneel down in a chair and pray for hours and cry. I remember I was at church as a kid and I'm watching my older brother cry at church. And what happens is there's some people that go to church and they really try to change their life. And they really want some kind of change. That's why most beginners go to church. They know they're doing something wrong and they try to look for a change. They think God is in a Christian church. But come to find out that is a lie.
Right.
So they do that and they cry. And then tomorrow you cry about the evil that you cry about your past. And then the next day you do the same evil, man.
Right.
And guess what? Your pastor never gives you any support or any willpower or any courage to build up to stop the evil or that you're doing or the sin that you committed, man.
Right.
The church has failed. The church has been around for hundreds of years, and it does not work, man. We got to understand that church, that God is not in the Christian church, and the Christian church is not going to help us stop sinning, man.
Right.
Only the IHPK under Commander Junior Hunter will help us stop getting high.
That's right.
Only the IHPK under Commander Junior Hunter will help us love one another.
That's right.
And finally get it right, like we always say.
That's right.
So,
right.
Y'all get that power priest and prophet a hand, man. He was absolutely right in what he was saying, man. Absolutely right. The Christian church has failed black people. The same way the Democrat Party has failed black people. The Republican Party has failed black people. The Civil Rights Movement has failed black people. Everything that we have tried to do as a people has failed. We gotta start to ask ourselves at some point, why is it that it seems like we cannot get ahead as a people? I'm not talking about individuals. The white man would allow a couple of us to get a lot of money so the rest of us can have something to aspire to be a sellout. But the majority of our people cannot prosper, man. Why is the majority of our people cannot prosper? Read it again. The Bible is telling us why. Read.
He that covereth his sins.
He that covereth his sins, man. The Bible says he that covereth his sins. What does that mean? Meaning if you are doing wrong and you refuse to admit you're doing wrong, if you refuse to change, you're covering your sins, man. And you can't do that. If you're wrong, you must change. Everybody understands that when they go to court. You go to court and you get a DUI. Let you not be in a drug, drinking class while you in court. The judge gonna be like, well, you was wrong and you not in the drinking class. You must not be trying to change.
Right.
You might as well go ahead. I might as well just throw you in jail.
Right.
But if you go to court and you can tell the judge, yeah, I know I was wrong. But, and you know, I know I got a DUI, but I'm currently in drinking classes. The judge sees, okay, he was wrong, but he's trying to change. And now you can actually progress. And that's why black people cannot prosper. Because we refuse to change when we are wrong as a people, man. It's wrong for black people to want to be American. It's wrong for black people to want to hold hands and join white people. It's wrong for us to love American culture, man. We don't understand that. It's wrong, and it's a sin against God. A lot of our people want to be Democrats and Republicans. When does that ever help black people? Black people thought Barack Obama was going to save our lives. Y'all remember that? Well, I ain't forget. That's what you desire. I remember that. Barack Obama, black people voted in Barack Obama in mass numbers. And what did he do for black people? I'll wait. What did Barack Obama do for black people? You hear the crickets? This is D.C. We should be the first ones to know what he did for black people if he were to do something. But guess what? He didn't do nothing, man. That's exactly what he did, brother. He did more damage, man. He did absolutely more damage to the black community. Barack Obama did more for gays in the gay community than he did for black people, man.
Right.
And we thought he was gonna save us. So why the hell we think some white man now is gonna save us? Why the hell we think some 70-something-year white man gonna save us? Joe Biden is not gonna save us. Donald Trump is not gonna save us. Kamala Harris is not gonna save us, man. The only thing that's gonna save our people is coming back to our laws. These laws are meant for black people to rule over the earth.
That's right.
I bet you didn't know the Bible is black supremacy.
That's right.
The Bible don't talk about equality. Your pastor says equality, equality. We wanna be equal and let's hold hands. That's not in the Bible. And that's why your pastor is causing the black community to be destroyed. Because the Bible doesn't talk about equality. The Bible says there's one people greater than the other people. You don't believe me? Y'all think I'm making that up? No sweat. Keep reading. I get it.
But whoso confesses or forsaketh them shall have mercy.
Read that again.
But whoso confesseth or forsaketh them shall have mercy.
Whoever forsakes that lifestyle that they're living, that it doesn't follow this book, the Lord will have mercy, man. Black people, don't act like you don't need mercy in this place. You know how you know we need mercy? That $2,000 was gonna be some mercy for us. That $600 stimulus check is some sense of mercy in this hell, man. We are the people that need mercy the most. The problem is, we're not doing the things to get it. Aren't we tired of hearing about our children being killed by stray bullets? Aren't we tired of hearing about black women going missing?
Right.
Aren't we tired of hearing about another brother killed by the police?
Right.
Aren't we tired of hearing about the things that we suffer as a people? We need some mercy, don't we? We need something to change. You probably say it every day, you probably just say it a different way. As you getting up early in the morning to go to some stupid job because the white man is the devil, you tell yourself, man, something gotta give. I know every black person say that in some type of form, like, man, this ain't it right here. Something gotta give. I can't be doing this too much longer. You understand? Because we need some mercy in this place. Our lives are full of suffering. And the way we get that mercy, it's not through begging a white man. It's not by loving American culture and wanting to be more American. Don't you understand? There's nothing we can do to get these oppressors to love us, man. You know what we can do? We can get our God to love us. We can get our power to love us, and that's what we need.
That's right.
The Lord wants black people to be on charge, be in charge.
Right.
Give me Deuteronomy 7:6. I'll prove it. It's one of my favorite scriptures right here. Because a lot of black people think that the Bible is equality. A lot of black people think that the Bible is saying we all the same, and we all can live in peace and harmony, holding hands as equals, and red-blooded human beings. That's garbage. That's in movies, folks. And that's not even a movie I would want to see. I want to see a movie where somebody's in charge and killing and winning. Everybody wants to see that because that's reality, man. There's no way, there's nowhere on earth where everybody's equal and the same and enjoying the same privileges. There's somebody in top and there's just somebody in the bottom. And guess what? What's unfortunate for us, everywhere on the earth we are the ones that's on the bottom. We are the ones living in poverty. You know what's crazy? You can go to West Side Chicago and look how we live. And then go to the west side of Baltimore and look how we live. And then go to Southeast DC and look how we live. And then go to Kingston, Jamaica, and look how we live. And then go to Brazil and see how we live. And then go to Honduras and Mexico City and see how we live. It's the same. You ever ask yourself, why is that? Why is it that niggas live the same everywhere they are? Because the Lord is trying to get us to understand we are not to live like everybody else. And the moment we choose to live like everybody else, we will serve everybody else.
Right.
And that's what's happening. We're not equal to these people. Black people, we serve America. Black people are not a partner, equal partners in America. Black people are the servants in America. We the ones that take out the trash. We the ones that's the maids. We the chefs cooking all the food. There wouldn't be no five-star restaurants in D.C. if it wasn't for the delivery drivers, the brothers, busting their backs, bringing their food in. The black and Hispanic chefs cooking the food. The black and Hispanic servers. You understand? Like, everything that America prides itself on is made possible by blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. But we're the servants. You understand? And we're the servants when the Lord intended for us to be in charge. I'll prove it. Read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7, verse 6. For thou art an holy people.
The Bible is saying that if you are black, Hispanic, and Native American, you are a holy people. And I'm going to give you some knowledge right now because the pastor is not going to do it. He clearly ain't never did it. The word holy does not mean going in that church and all that garbage and running laps around the church and sweating and falling out. That's not what holy means. You understand? Holy is a word just like any other word. It has a definition just like any other word. And the definition for the word holy in Hebrew means to be separate. The
right.
Hebrew word for holy is kodash. And kodash in Hebrew means to be separate. You understand? This is a little knowledge right here, because the church is not going to do it. The church is going to sing and dance you to death, and you're going to go home to hell. The same way we all used to. Right? The Lord is saying we are separate people. Keep reading.
Unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God has chosen thee.
The Lord thy God has chosen thee. Now, if God loved everybody, why is it saying that God chose a certain set of people? Now let's break this down for a minute. You do know if you choose something, that means something is not getting chosen. Perfect example, if you go into the club, and it's a dime piece in the club, but she choosing, if you didn't get chose, you are excluded. You're not going home with her. Well, guess what? That's what the Lord is saying. He chose a certain set of people, and anybody that didn't get chose by the Most High, they are excluded in what this is talking about. The beautiful thing about this is, if you're black, Hispanic, or Native American, you are the ones that were chosen. You are the ones who this book was intended for. Thank you, brother. This knowledge is not for nobody else. Hell, I'll help you. The reason why we think snakes talk in the Bible is because we let some people who this book doesn't pertain to interpret it. When you let the white man get a hold of our records and our books, he's going to destroy it. Thank you, brother. The white man said Adam and Eve was naked talking to a snake. Has anybody ever seen a snake talk before? Has anybody? Go. Come on, man. Right, and I talk about when you high, when that gas that kicked in. Right? Because some brother was like, well, actually, I do know a python. Now listen, man. Snakes don't talk. Does that even make sense? But this is what we believe growing up, because we let the white man interpret our records right here, our historical records. The same way right now, I'll show you. If I were to say, I'm about to head to the crib with my dogs, and after that, I'm gonna go see about this bad piece, this dime piece. The white man's gonna think you heading to a baby's sleeping place with puppies with change in your pocket. He never understand what you're saying. Like, you go to the crib with your dogs, you got a dime piece. What is that? What are you saying? You know who understands what I'm saying? Y'all do. That's why you shook your head. Like, yeah, that's not, you talking regular. But to the white man, it's foreign. And that's why they should not be reading and interpreting our book to us, because they're going to get it wrong every single time. This knowledge is pertaining to one set of people. It was written by us. When the Bible says Eve was deceived by a snake, what do black people call a snake today? A shiesty individual. If I say that nigga is a snake, we ain't talking about that nigga is, it can transform into a reptile. We saying he's low down, you can't trust him. If we say that's my dog, we ain't saying this brother's a pit bull. We say this is my homie. You know what I'm saying? That's how we talk. The Bible's talking to us, and this Bible's saying that we have been chosen. Keep reading.
A special people.
A what?
Special people.
A special people, man. The Lord says we are a special people. Not only does he say we are special, I'm about to blow your minds and break your hearts with this, Christians. All you, if you follow Martin Luther King and you love Martin Luther King and his philosophy, I'm going to blow your mind and break your heart. Because this is what the Bible says. Read.
Unto himself.
No, read.
To be a special people unto himself. Above all people.
Above all people. For all you Martin Luther King fans out there, what did Martin Luther King Jr. want for black people? He wanted black people to hold hands and sit together. I'll help you. I have a dream that little black boys and little white girls can sit together at the table of brotherhood and all that garbage. I thought Martin Luther King Jr. was a reverend. I thought he was a pastor. So ain't pastors supposed to read from the Bible? So how the hell is Martin Luther King Jr. talking about equality when the Bible just said there is one set of people special and above all other people? Either the Bible was lying or Martin Luther King Jr. was lying. I'll help you. Don't try to think about it. He was lying, man. He also was sleeping with white women in the Watergate Hotel. You understand? That's your leader. And that's your pastor. Because the pastors don't love black people. The pastors are sellouts for the white man. The same way black politicians are. The same way black entertainers and athletes are, man. We have a culture. And the Lord says we are special and above all people. Give me Revelation 18:4. I'm going to show you something. I'm going to show you how the Lord wants to destroy America, but he's not doing it yet because he's waiting on us to change. I'm going to show you something. Do you know the coronavirus was not intended for black people? Did you know that? Did you know the coronavirus was not intended for blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans? Probably like, whoa, what you mean? What you mean? Look at all the conspiracy theorists. Eyes got wide. Exactly. The white man made it in the laboratory. We've been telling y'all. No, that's not what I'm talking about. Simmer down, simmer down. What I'm saying is the Lord brought COVID-19 to the earth. And the Lord wants to destroy America and kill our oppressors. But because we still want to do what our oppressors do, we're dying from a disease that was meant for them. We're dying from something that they should have been dying from only. Well, it's not supposed to be like that. And I'll show you, the Bible proves what I'm saying. Everything I'm saying, I'm approving. Read.
The book of Revelation, chapter 18:4.
The Lord loves us so much that in our poverty, in our hand, I'm going to come and deliver the broken, destroyed, messed up, poor, impoverished people. I'm going to help.
Hey, Shalom Israel. Yahweh Bashim Yah Shah Brother Thug. Yahweh Shema Allah Thug Bashim Yah Shah to all the sisters, man. Listen, it's Captain 13,000, the Card of a Rhyme, checking in with the Israelite School of UPK under Commander Junior Hunt. Listen, man, this year's 52nd annual Passover. Hold on, I'm gonna say it one more time. This year's 52nd 32nd annual Passover under Commander Jerry and Hunter under the ISUPK. Couldn't do it last year. Y'all already know the Lord had his foot on our oppressor's neck.
Here in New York City, there are roughly 1,000 cases a day. Those are numbers they haven't seen since May.
Can't do it in New York this year because the Lord still got his foot on our oppressor's neck.
New York, the center of the outbreak this spring, is now teetering on another deadly explosion of the virus.
But listen to me good. This year, 52nd annual Passover, April 24th, 2021. You understand? It's going to be in H-Town, baby.
It's going to be at the B&H Ranch, 14149 Player Street, Houston, Texas.
Y'all know what we do. Y'all know what we came to do. Huh? 2021, ISUPK, 52nd annual Passover. All the generals gonna be there. All the heavy hitters gonna be there. The daughters of Zion gonna step out with their beautiful long dresses, you understand? Strong on deck. That One West style music on deck. 52nd annual Passover.
B&H Ranch, 14149 Player Street, Houston, Texas.
Get with it to get lost, man.
Got it out the mud, straight up out the base. The world done made me crazy. The world done turned crazy. You dealing with the